Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm TWK of TWK Reviews, and welcome to my review of WWE 2K20, released on the PS4 just a couple weeks ago. By the time you see this video, we've had this video out sooner, but unfortunately, number one, I got sick, and then number two, a whole bunch of work stuff in real life piled up, so yeah, sorry about that. Also, despite it being past Halloween, still going with a bit of a gimmick here. We'll have to come up with something more professional together, but unfortunately time ran out on that, so I guess this is the best we got. Kind of fitting, considering what I'm reviewing today, a game which has kind of a similar reputation, something that felt like it was thrown together at the last moment. Let's see if any of that is just over-exaggerated, or if this game really does have that many problems under the hood.
First, let's start with the gameplay. Most notably, how they changed the controls. I mean, just look at this screen. They really did just arbitrarily change the controls, because normally, in past years, whenever they make any sort of major changes to the control scheme, it's done to, in service to some sort of new mechanic. This was not done here. Instead, it just felt really, really arbitrary, like some top executives were like, okay, we haven't changed the control scheme in like 5 or 6 years, so let's go ahead and do that, just because we feel like the control scheme is getting old. But if you're going to do that, you have to replace it for a reason. You can't just scramble around the controls and just so frustrating. It's taking me so many days to get used to these new controls, because anytime I hit one button, I'm like, oh no, that doesn't do that thing that I wanted to do. And because of that, I often got my ass kicked. Another critique I have is the fact that the AI seems very reversal heavy in this game, way more than usual. And yes, I did turn the reversal sliders down as far as I could, but unless the game is set on easy, then the AI is going to be taking you straight to Reversal City, and there's going to be no detours along the way. Two quick critiques I want to get to right away is the fact that, number one, there are no new match types in the game, so if you're expecting to play as a special referee or an I Quit match, then, well, nope, still gonna have to wait at least one more year for that. And on top of that, there's no creative belt at launch. At the very least, that should be coming in a later patch, but, you know, we don't know. Will it? Guess we'll find out. As far as the roster goes, it's as large as usual. I mean, I think this is something we've come to expect in recent years when it comes to WWE games, with my favorite inclusions being Mandrews, Mia Yim, Toni Storm, and Rhea Ripley. You may have noticed that a few of those names are from NXT UK. Now, is the NXT UK brand actually represented in the game? Not really, except for the NXT UK TakeOver Arena. There's no Imperium, there's no NXT Championships, aside from the one that's already been in the game for the past few years, so yeah, that's another disappointment added up to the tally. This year's showcase focuses on the four horsewomen of NXT, and at this point you're either going to like the mode or you're not. I'm not sure what I can honestly say about this really, other than that it is well presented. It's basically what you would expect to see at this point, though. You got interview segments, match objectives, and in-game cutscenes. I don't think there's going to be anything here that's going to particularly blow people away, but if you like previous showcases, then you'll probably enjoy this one, especially if you're a fan of that era of NXT as I was. As for the career mode, here you actually create both a male and a female wrestler, which is different than what I was expecting. I was, you know, expecting going in, you're going to have to create either a male or a female, and you have two separate career modes, but nope, it is just one career mode focusing on these two characters, and I'll get back to them in a moment, because first, I have some more bitching to do. First off, the fucking loot boxes are back, and I know it doesn't use real currency, but that is the only positive thing I can say about it, because just as a concept, I do not like loot boxes at all, and I don't care what the game calls it, they're loot boxes. It doesn't matter how you dress them up, how you present them, all loot boxes function the same. And here is my major problem. Instead of just choosing what I want to unlock, I'm choosing just a random chance of getting what I want, so maybe I'll get it on the first try, maybe I'll get it on the 1,000th try. Either way, I don't like it, it doesn't feel rewarding, it feels cheap, it feels manipulative, I don't like it, it's bullshit! And speaking of bullshit, this skill tree, which is really not that well designed at all. If you want a well-designed skill tree, may I point you in the direction of the Borderlands series, or perhaps The Witcher 3. Hell, even Fist of the North Star Lost Paradise has a pretty well-designed skill tree. But this game? Nope! Instead, you're just picking skills at random, hoping that the next one somehow correlates to the one you chose, but 9 times out of 10, it does not. Also, I must ask, why the hell does a wrestling game need a skill tree to begin with? Now, going back to the main characters we play as for this career mode, because I want to end this segment on a positive note, these two are gigantic wrestling nerds, and I love it, mainly because they're just 100% unabashed wrestling nerds. They don't give a fuck. They're like, yes, I love wrestling, and I'm going to showcase that 100% of the time if I can. And just the fact that they lean into that so much, and yes, some of it is a little cringy, but then again, you know, I think we've all seen wrestling fans do things that are a bit cringy and make us go, oh, why are you doing that? But at the same time, the fact that we're seeing it here as our protagonists and the way they're acted and portrayed is just, I can't hate it. I love it. I can't not love it. And I've been trying to find out who voices these two characters, but my search has come up fruitless. So if you know who voices these two, please put all the information my way. I would love to know who whose two voice actors are. And now I'm going to leave you with a clip of this good old-fashioned cringiness.
This truly is a historic day. I don't think I've seen you dressed up since our senior prom.
Oh yeah, our one and only date together because no one else would go with us.
I remember showing up in that sweet homemade million-dollar man suit. Didn't you wear a cane mask? No wonder we couldn't get dates.
To be fair, the theme of the prom was a masquerade.
Still weird.
And now for the elephant in the room, aka this game's glitches. And sorry to be a tiny bit of a wet blanket, but I can count the amount of glitches I've gotten in this game on one hand, with at least a couple of fingers left over. So I'm not saying that glitches aren't a running rampant in this game, but they just haven't really been doing so for me, so yeah, I can't really call this game a glitch-riddle mess on my part. You know, just like a wrestling referees, if I don't see it, I can't call it, and I don't see very many glitches with my playthrough so far. Maybe as I go through the story mode more, or maybe as I continue with the 2K showcase, the glitches will become more apparent, but as it stands right now, I just haven't seen very many glitches. I'm sorry.
Overall, this isn't the worst game I've ever played, but it's far from the best. Far, 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 and yet somehow I don't regret spending money on it. Yeah, I know buying a product this flawed doesn't help the system at all, but I just, I've played so much worse that something like this doesn't even faze me at this point. I mean, once you play Thunder, nothing gets to you, really. Nevertheless, I can't recommend anyone buying this new, and from what I've seen, not very many people have this year, and those that did have gotten quite the generous refund. Thankfully, though, the horizon is quite bright for wrestling games, as we have the Chikara video game coming to consoles next year, and on top of that, there's the Retromania video game coming out on consoles next year as well. And on top of that, there's the AEW video game coming out that really hopefully will invoke that AKI spirit. Really, really hoping on that one. Anyways, that is the video, ladies and gentlemen, and everyone in between. Be sure to click like, comment, and subscribe, or click like and subscribe, and also comment. Ooh, the sickness has now left my brain completely. Until next time, this is TWK of TWK Reviews, telling you to work your gimmick, and I'm going to do something a lot more positive for the next video. I'm not sure what this is. I don't know why I'm continuing doing it. End the video, please, before I do something even more stupid.